Eddie, man. Wow. I think it was the seventh grade. First day of school. Hey, can I borrow a pencil? That started a friendship that lasted to right now. And I'm happy to celebrate today with you and your beautiful bride. I hope your friendship runs as deep as Eddie's and I.
Christiane is the epitome of perseverance, the continued effort to do or achieve something despite difficulties, failure, or opposition.
She is such a phenomenal woman in every aspect. She has such a great presence.
Too deep for more, I see the less I know. I live for this clarity when you're louder than my thoughts that keep me low. Ooh, and just for some turns of the hand, it all seems good.
Brothers and sisters, family and friends, we are gathered here today to unite Edward Drake II and Christiane Francisco in marriage. Marriage is a commitment between a man and a woman, for scripture tells us and the two shall become one. Marriage is also a covenant by and with God and should not be entered into lightly or inadvisably, but in prayer and in submission to God's holy word and in the fear of Him.
My love has come along.
Before you, I thought that love was this fickle emotion that wavers and usually dies with time. And then at one of my darkest moments, when most would have ran, you drew nearer. During a time when I couldn't pray for myself, you interceded for me. You demonstrated and continue to give me the love of Christ. You're an amazing man of God who serves the Lord with your whole heart. I can't wait to continue building a Christ-centered life and be the Michelle to your Barack. I love you.
First day, we locked eyes at New Birth Christian Ministries during my play-your days. You are an usher and attended weekly Bible studies, which then I quickly made my routine. Although our first date was horrible, as we appeared to have nothing in common but our love for the Lord, a few months later, we tried a second date, and you accepted my invitation to watch Beauty and the Beast. We made it through 4 years long distance relationship, as Proverbs 18:22 states, "He who finds a wife finds a good thing." I'm thankful the Lord brought us together, kept us, and blessed us, and will continue to do so as long as we remain obedient to the Lord.
Join hands. That's the only reason you came to Bible study. It gives me a great honor and a privilege to pronounce you are now husband and wife. And Edward, you may kiss your bride.
Thank you.
I dive too deep, the more I see, the less I know. I live for this clarity when you're louder than my thoughts that keep me low.
I just want you to know I love you. You made a wonderful choice with Edward. And I just love both of you. And have a wonderful life.
Today, I can truly say, and I believe, that God has ordained this marriage. And I say, welcome, daughter, to the family. And I say to you, Woody, thank you for choosing wise. Thank you.
My new son-in-law. On behalf of my wife, me, and the whole Francisco family, welcome. Welcome to the family.
Build on your love for each other, continuing in a lifetime of joy and happiness. And you guys made it 4 years long distance. Now you have a lifetime to go.
Thank you for loving my friend, for who she is. And I know she can be a handful just based off of this wedding planning alone. Thank you for being the kind of man that never tries to change her or dim her light. Today, when you two became one, you're my best friend too. And I promise that I'll never take sides.